when I was still in primary school. A classmate of mine's father was a manager at the cinema. And then after school, we used to go, you know, around to the cinema. I used to run straight upstairs to the projection booth. And I thought, wow, you know, I saw the projectors running, the noise of the projectors, you know, you know, it just amazed me. It just caught my attention and I was like really into it. The projectionist then saw me in the booth and he said, what are you doing here? Get out of here, you're not supposed to be in here. I ran down the stairs. Next day I was there again until he just got tired of me and he accepted me in his booth, and that was my introduction to film. Where I grew up, we were like exposed to spaghetti westerns, you know, and karate movies. So that's basically all we saw, spaghetti westerns and karate movies, and the odd Flash Gordon. First movie I screened and saw here was Zonde Florette. And I watched a little bit of this movie and I said, what the hell is this? How can people still watch? And we had a cinema, was like packed to capacity. And I was wondering, why are these people sitting here wasting their money on movies like this, you know? I didn't know that type of movies, you know? And I said, no man, I'm not gonna watch this. This is, you know, rubbish. And then I had nothing else. I had nothing to do. I was just sitting waiting for movies to finish. So when I just went inside the cinema and I sat down and I watched. I thought, maybe I'm gonna fall asleep there and have a nice nap, you know. And then I started watching the film and I caught interest, you know. And I thought, wait a minute. This is something else, you know. This is magic. Because what I'm seeing there is what's happening every day, you know, this is real life. What I've seen before, that's not real life, that is make-believe, you know, that's entertainment, this is real life. And that's how I discovered art house movies, like they say, you know, and ever since I'm hooked. The projectors I work with, okay, they're like, one is about 40 years old and they've all been modernized, you know, to take the big reels that we use now. We get the film, it's in like 6 different cans. Then what I have to do is I have to take it out, see whether it's on the beginning or the end, and then I have to splice it together with my little splicer. Okay, take off all the leaders and I splice it together. And that's what I love, the feel of film on my fingers, you know. And after I've spliced it, depending on whether it's head out or tail out, then I have to rewind it. Then I have to load it on the projector. Once it's ready, then I can start my movie. Everything is going digital very soon. Like I believe in South Africa, within a year's time, everything is going digital. And projectors are gonna become obsolete, you know? And that like really saddens me because I've been working with these kind of things, projectors for, I won't call them things because I have a passion for them. So they are projectors, they have a name. One day they're gonna be worth nothing. They're gonna maybe stand in a museum or end up on a rubbish dump, you know. As you can see, I'm very emotional about these things, you know. I spend more time with these projectors than I spend with my family, you know. So I take those projectors as my family because I spend more time with them than my own family. I hardly saw my kid. He's 17 years old now. I hardly saw him grow up, but I'm with those projectors every single day. I know what the ailments are. I know just by listening to these projectors, if anything is gonna go wrong with it. I can hear, I can listen. My ear is trained with this noise. Any slight noise that's different, I know, it needs a bit of oil, or a gear is going, or, you know? I just know something is gonna happen because I'm with them, you can say 12, 13 hours a day. I would love to take one home, you know. I would like to have it in my living room. It's just a showpiece, yeah. And I've got my eye on one. I've got my favorite projector. I like to see the scratch, you know, or the line running through the foam, or, you know. Then I know I'm watching celluloid, you know. I don't know if I'm going to have a job. That's what worries me. Because if it goes digital, they don't need a projectionist. There's not going to be any films for me to load on the projector. There's not going to be any projectors to oil, do sound checks, mirrors to clean. So no film to be made up, no film to be spliced. So I don't think it's going to be a job for me. This is all I can do, projecting film. You know, I don't know anything else. I don't know what I'm going to do.